I come from a tiny island called Sri Lanka, cricket crazy country, and I was the chief executive officer of Sri Lankan cricket board and also the manager of the winning World Cup team in 1996. When I came to Oman, I was so happy and pleased to see the backing given by the government of Oman and the royal family. My main concern in Oman as a chief development officer is to see that more and more Omanis take up this beautiful game, cricket. Towards that goal, I could see all the development work coming up, and I was so happy to see the second green ground coming up in Oman. And towards that goal, everyone is getting together and working together, and to see that the development in Oman cricket is of paramount importance.
Year 2000 was a watershed year down for Oman cricket. Oman cricket was recognized first by the ICC and then immediately after by the ACC. This brought about a lot of recognition to Oman for having done well in the ACC tournaments and the ICC tournaments. But what needed to be done was to really develop cricket at various levels. We had a lot of opportunity in what we were developing, but we didn't know how to, and the biggest constraint was, of course, finance. But with the introduction of the ICC and the ACC funds, with the adaptation of various programs that they had, we were able to kind of start developing our grassroots infrastructure. We started developing grounds. We started at least the notion of having a green ground, for one. And it was quite evident that without having a green turfed wicket, we were not able to compete on level playing fields at various tournaments hosted by the ICC and ACC. So on a little farm outside of Muscat, my father, the president of Cricket Oman, Mr. Kanak Kimji, developed a turfed playing wicket for net practices, so that the teams, before going on tournaments, could start getting a real feel of what turf wicket's all about. So that was really a turning point. And then, of course, our funds started increasing with the help of the ACC and ICC contributions. And this gave us the impetus that we should be able to sustain a green ground, a full turf wicket. And that started our process of having a full turf wicket at Amarat. Ministry of Sports in Oman was very kind enough to give us a near 70,000 square meter plot of land on which we developed two grounds. One, we started to turf, and it came out beautifully well. We've had a whole season now, and that really also was a turning point in a lot of other cricket development, in the sense that we were able to have schools cricket tournaments on the turf ground on Thursdays and Fridays, while we had our league tournaments on Saturdays, etc. The level of cricket improved considerably, but more importantly, the number of playing teams improved considerably from a sheer 50-odd teams or 60-odd teams in 2011 to a huge 85 teams plus in 2013-14. So I think people's aspirations grew, our deliverance started getting better with those aspirations. So it was a matter of expectations and deliverance. So I think we've benefited a lot from the green turf, thanks to the ACC, thanks to the ICC, to our donors, to our well-wishers. And now we've got a very, very interesting development program called the 3-5-10, which means in 3 years we want 300 local nationals playing cricket at schools level. In 5 years we want 500 nationals playing cricket at schools and league level. And in 10 years' time, our wish is that we will have nationals, Omani nationals, playing cricket at schools, league and national level. Last year we were the beneficiaries of a royal grant from His Majesty, and this endowment has laid the foundations setting up and developing up cricket at grassroots level. So with the 3-5-10 program that I just talked about and our vision for cricket, we also said that we need to make sure that our development program is well nurtured, is well mentored, and when monitored, and who else but the MCC from Lords that we could find, and we thought that there would be the right people, the right organization to nurture us, to really handhold us through this whole process. So we are indebted to the MCC, to the likes of Mike Griffith, Mike Gatting, John Stevenson, and the whole team, Derek Brewer, who really endorse this program of ours and are now helping us shape our infrastructure development and our people development initiative for the 3-5-10 program. So I really thank MCC for their efforts as well. So that's our goal, that's our vision going forward. Thank you.